is Cosmos Indoor Soccer. From the Forum in Montreal, Canada, the Cosmos meet the Montreal Manic. Brought to you in part by Budweiser, the king of beers. Reach for that distinctively clean, crisp taste that says Budweiser. For all you do, this Bud's for you. And by Getty, who wants you to get the most out of your car. And by Listerman Mouthwash, the mouthwash that helps you get up your confidence. And by Joe Manfredi's Safe Toyota. Good evening, everyone, from the Forum in Montreal, Canada. Jim Carbellis and Seamus Mallon. This building literally reeks with tradition. When I think of this building and look at it, I think of the Howie Morenzes, reading about them anyway, the Maurice Rocket Richards. But tonight, we're not talking about NHL hockey. We're talking about NASL indoor soccer. And we're talking about the Chinaglias and the Gordon Hills and the Carlos Albertos. Tonight, the Cosmos take on Montreal, a team they played some marvelous games against last year, and they're not doing as well indoors, Seamus, as they did outdoors.
Well, there's four spectacular matches last summer, and they're both having indoor problems. You're quite right. And the same kinds of problems, Jim. They do not seem to be used to the boards yet. They're having a little bit of trouble with the tactics of this game, man up and man down situations. And more than anything else, in recent matches, both teams have had scoring good chances in front.
Another reason this is a great rivalry is that Eddie Firmani is the coach of the Montreal club, a man that helped the Cosmos win two championships. And you know that Eddie would love to beat the Cosmos.
Last season we had some great games against the Cosmos, and I feel that they were a little bit lucky to beat us last year in the four occasions we played them. We had a great preseason game with the Cosmos, and we're hoping to turn things around. They play some great soccer, you know, and we've matched them all the way down the line, so tonight we're hoping to change the things around.
All right, with an 18-game season, Seamus, every game becomes more important. The Cosmos in the same division with Montreal, they're 1-2. The top club is Toronto, 3-2. They were beaten the other day, so the Cosmos and Montreal are even with them in the loss column. Tonight's very, very important.
Well, this is the third game on the road for the Cosmos, and anytime you go to somebody else's park or indoor facility, you really are the underdog. And tonight, Montreal very much wants to get back in their winning ways, because this is a stadium that has a winning tradition, and the local people do not want to see a losing team here.
Cosmos and Montreal here in Montreal. We'll be back with Cosmos Indoor Soccer in a moment.
...1950 Coney Island Avenue in Brooklyn.
All right, the game is underway. The Cosmos in the blue uniforms, Montreal in the white. And the Cosmos with Daryl G at the Montreal line retreats back to Chinaglia. Cosmos have Ricky Davis on the ball now. Escondarian with it on the right boards as he comes up that right side. Daryl G, Moyers on the starting line. Montreal going with Fran O'Brien, tying up Daryl G and call for the foul. Voesmaer is in there. Hill. Parkinson. And Mike Yaremovich in the goal. Bobby Rigby, the former Cosmos player, and David Bursich in the goal for the Cosmos. Game just underway. This is Rick Davis. Gets it over to Chinaglia at the Montreal line. There's Giorgio, a little back heel to Moyers. Moyers in the left corner now. Back to Giorgio at the point. Giorgio gets booed every time he touches the ball. Nice pass to G. Fires the shot and misses. Daryl G with the ball. Off the boards nicely to Rick Davis. And a bad pass is picked off by Yaremovich, reacquired by Davis. Cosmos controlling it. Chinaglia knocked it into the seats.
Giorgio trying to play that ball around the boards that time, I think. Just got under it a bit too much and got it over. But good possession already by the Cosmos. Daryl G in particular looking very strong and sturdy in the corner as Gordon Hill was unable to get by him.
Keep in mind that when the Cosmos won that 7-6 exhibition game against Montreal, Chinaglia did not play. Moyers had the hat trick, with Giorgio playing here in Montreal indoors for the first time. Voesmaer. Parkinson heads it back for Hill. Gordon Hill fires, and a great save by Bursich. Parkinson. Parkinson trying to get it in front to Hill. A nice play again by David Persich. Persich has been the brightest light, I think, Shannon, for the Cosmos in these three games.
He certainly has, and even in that very bad loss in Toronto, 8-2, he nonetheless was a star of the game as far as the Cosmos are concerned. It's something unusual to say when a keeper gives up eight goals, but they were not his fault.
Juremovic's pass for Hill gets by him. Bursic, long release to Giorgio, leaves it for Daryl G. Daryl G, starting tonight, out of Davis at the point. Marked by Parkinson, got by along the boards. Here comes Ricky. Off the boards, trying to get it in front, but it was smothered. The rebound smothered by Rigby, and a long throw that Eskandarian picks off for the Cosmos. Eskie to Rick Davis. No score in the game. Nelson Moraes now on for the Cosmos. He replaces Daryl G. And that's Usian, number 10, on for Montreal. Familiar name, Shane.
Yeah,
Usian and Hill.
That's right. Outstanding here as a rookie outdoors this summer, and I understand he's looked very good indoors already.
Into the corner for Hill, but beaten to the ball by Eskandarian. Ferdinando De Mateus on for the Cosmos now, their rookie number 29. Here's Nelson Moraes. Second only to Chinaglia in scoring. De Mateus off the boards, blocked down nicely by Juremovic, number 24. Out to Nelson Moraes, a shot blocked down by Voesmaer, the brilliant sweeper. Now intercepted by Erhard Kapp. Kapp to Giorgio. Back to Kapp. In front to Giorgio, deflected, almost an own goal, but Rigby with a brilliant reflex save. Voesmaer, Usian. They've got Hill on the left side. And the pass to Hill. He's one-on-one, and the shot is headed away. A great play by Erhard Kapp to save a goal, Seamus.
Absolutely. Erhard Kapp trailing back beautifully there. He had made the rush forward, remember. He had to come a long way back. Now, that's a good ball that beats two players. Usian drills it over to Hill. Hill takes a little bit of time to get that little chip in, and in comes Kapp to save it.
All right, Carlos Alberto on for the Cosmos. Now to Moyers. Cosmos changing players very quickly, Seamus, here in the early going. Moraes lost the ball, and Hill gives it right back to Nelsi and out of Giorgio, and Moyers is in front. Chinaglia had it tackled away by O'Brien. Alberto tries to fire it in the slot for Moyers. Now it's Chinaglia with the ball. Giorgio, easy for Rigby. And a long throw for Hill. Hill touched the ball and went over the crowd into the bench, the Montreal bench.
And it's early going for the Cosmos. 4 minutes have already gone. They've had some of the sharpest passing that I've seen in some time. They had some real struggles with their passing against Toronto, but so far they're finding each other quite well, except for that time.
All right, Hayden Knight is in now for Montreal, number 17, and Alan Woolley. Alberto on the ball, back to Bursic. Fires for Chinaglia. Sutevsky, the veteran defender on Giorgio. Giorgio got it back for Erhard Kapp. Kapp with it. I guess Hayden Knight fires for Bandoff in the corner, but Rigby knocked it away. Now Riggs getting back to the goal, and it's finally picked up by Carmine Marcantonio. Long throw. Alan Woolley leaves it for Sutevsky. This is Woolley battling with Moyers. Crossfield pass by Dusian. Usian with Kapp. Shot is deflected by Alberto. Usian, little give and go with Woolley. Now bangs it out in front for Moyers. Bandoff on for the Cosmos. Chinaglia back heel for Bandoff. He's held up by Hayden Knight. That should be obstruction on Hayden Knight.
Yes.
Peter H. Johnson, the referee.
Definite obstruction there. It was a good piece of work along the boards there by Bandoff, Moyers and Chinaglia. And Bandoff just bowled over as he cut for the third pass.
Alberto, a drive from outside. Moyers couldn't get the follow-up. Long drive by Carlos. Now Alberto at the point. To Chinaglia to Carlos. He drives again. It's off the mark. Now chip back to Rigby. Firing out now to Woolley. In the corner now, and Bursic beat Usian to the ball. The goalkeepers in this game have to be very active, not only in front of the goal, but also in the corner. Here comes Usian in Cosmos zone. Sutevsky with him, so's Woolley. And now a foul on Damir Sutevsky.
A good play by Rick Davis there, who got around Sutevsky very nicely. Sutevsky thought he had him boxed out, and Ricky Davis slipped the inner shoulder there, got by, and Sutevsky reached out and pulled him back. You're quite right about David Bursich's play there a minute ago. These keepers have got to play to feet, Jim, and a lot of American goalkeepers perhaps are lacking a bit in their foot skills, but the indoor game may help them develop those skills a bit.
All right, the Cosmos now have band off on Eskandarian, Rick Davis, Giorgio Chinaglia, and Steve Wegele. Montreal coming with Marc Antonio. They have Parkinson, Hayden Knight, Sutevsky, Alan Willey, and this is Parkinson. Sutevsky off his foot. Marc Antonio collects back to Sutevsky. In the corner for Alan Willey. Davis marking. Davis foul. Foul on Rick Davis. It'll be a free kick from the right boards corner. In the slot. Parkinson had a block nicely by Eskandarian. Now Alan Willey acquires and Bandoff beat him to the ball. Willey took it away. Back to the front. Davis got it out of the slot nicely. Steve Wegele on for the first time tonight, Seamus. A little back heel for Georgia. Willey read it. Now racing, it's Parkinson. A hard drive that's knocked out of the slot by Eskandarian and into the crowd. One thing about the goals here, Seamus, we have boards behind the goals here. So when the ball does go in, we were watching in practice, it comes out very, very quickly.
Also, I think I'm impressed so far by Eskandarian's play. Esky has dropped back a lot into that central defensive position, and he's been right there when that ball has come off the boards to the right or left of Dave Bursich.
That was a good defensive play by Daryl G to knock it out of the slot. And now the Cosmos lose it and reacquire with Chinaglia. And now tackle away by Marc Antonio. And this is Gordon Hill, great little player. Marc Antonio, banged by Daryl G, and there's going to be a foul on Marc Antonio.
That's a good call. That's a very good call. Marc Antonio clearly playing G before he got to the ball, Marc Antonio, got to the ball there, and Peter Johnson very much on the mark.
Nice pass to Wegele from Chinaglia. Wegele waiting for it to come off the boards, finally got it off the boards, but couldn't get a foot on it. He was marked by Sutevsky. Here's Montreal. Franny O'Brien, G getting back. Parkinson's open. He drives it off the glass. Brooke Hill just missed. And a follow is tipped over the top by David Bursich. And a lot of action in front of the Cosmos goal. Now we have corner kick coming up for Montreal. Corner for Montreal. 7:41 to play in a scoreless first period at the Forum in Montreal. The famed Forum. Blocked down by DeMatteis. Now chipped in front. And a shot by O'Brien over the top. This program is authorized on the rights granted by the Cosmos solely for the entertainment of our audience. Any publication, rebroadcast, or other use of the pictures, descriptions, and accounts of this event, including the imposition of a charge for viewing this program without the express written consent of the Cosmos, is prohibited. DeMatteis scrambled it back to Bursich under pressure from O'Brien. Now the long throw to Daryl G. And there's speed to burn there. Hussein and Daryl G. They can really motor. And G just outran him and stripped him of the ball. Hussein was mad there because nobody told him that G was there. Cap. His shot deflected into the box and rolled back to the goalkeeper, Bobby Rigby. G is a wonderful natural athlete, Seamus. He's still a youngster and still has things to learn, but he has all the tools. He shot missed. Lucien trying to knock it in, and a good play by Kapp to deflect it away.
Erhard Kapp is such a valuable member of this team. He really covers up well, gets in front of those shots.
Here's Alberto with his space. He wound up to hit it again. Alberto's taken three shots tonight from long range. Carlos starting to fire the ball, Seamus.
A lot of the defenders, of course, are watching the players in front for the Cosmos, like Chinaglia and DeMatteis in that case. So, of course, it's important for Carlos to come through and have a go at goal, knowing that the rebound may go his way anyhow.
All right, the ball to Hill in the corner now in Cosmos zone. Knocked it away, but Alberto won it from Hill. Carlos, beautiful skill. DeMatteis making a run on the left side. Chinaglia has it. Giorgio, now to DeMatteis in the corner. Shielding the ball out. DeMatteis. Ferdinando. To Carlos. Alberto at the line. A chip toward Giorgio, headed away by Usian. When you're an offensive player in this game, that's not all you play. You've got to go both ways in indoor soccer, Shane, as we saw Ussian back in his own box heading it away.
And I think that's been one of the problems for Montreal. I know that in the newspapers today they were complaining, Eddie Firmani was complaining about the lack of discipline of some of his players and not working hard enough.
Alberto, a touch to Moyers. Steve Moyers in the game. Up that right wing. For Giorgio. Marias, and he missed. Cap, and he missed. And now Nelson with the ball. Off the glass, high in the air, and into the crowd. He tried to bang it off the glass to Chinaglia, who was in front. And the Cosmos using the boards and the glass quite a bit, Shane.
They are. They look like they've really learned some lessons since that last game with Toronto, which was, frankly, a bit of a humiliating experience up there in Maple Leaf Garden. But tonight, they looked like they were playing a much smarter type of game, using the walls very well.
Juramovic now a chip easy for David Bursich, who fires to Alberto, put under pressure. Carlos had it taken away by Hayden Knight. Now stolen by Bandoff to Giorgio. Chinaglia, a little backfield to Alberto. One touch nicely to Bandoff. Good return to Giorgio. Nice passing pattern. Moyers is in the slot. Chinaglia fires off the glass too hard. Glass is pretty lively. A drive by Alberto.
Boy, that didn't miss by much. Tremendous half volley there by Carlos.
Carlos is hitting the shot, Seamus. Here's Bandoff from the outside. Well, the Cosmos have not been shooting a lot, Seamus. And it looks like they're taking more shots on goal. Moyers to Giorgio. No score. 4:41 to play in the first period. Moyers knocked off the ball by Rigby, who came out. Rigby had enough of his defense and couldn't throw the ball. He cleared it. Ricky Davis and Willie. And that's a save. Nice save by Bursich. There's Hayden Knight working, trying to get free, and it's blocked by Bandoff. Good play by Boris. Voesmaer. Voesmaer over the line. There's a drive into the crowd. Indoor soccer, the Cosmos way, returns to the Meadowlands Arena next Tuesday night, December the 29th at 7:30, when the Cosmos host the Jacksonville T-Men. Make the new craze of Cosmos indoor soccer the highlight of your Christmas vacation week. That's the Cosmos against the T-Men in the easily accessible and beautiful Meadowlands Arena on Tuesday night, December the 29th at 7:30. No score, a foul, Montreal. It's again Parkinson with 4:06 to play. No score in the first period, Seamus.
Well, the Cosmos defensively looked a lot sharper too, Jim. They're blocking out in front quite well. Not too many players getting in the box the way they were in that second period in Toronto.
Moyers lost it. Fran O'Brien. Nice ball to Parkinson at the Cosmo line at the right point. Davis marking in. Off the boards now, comes back to Parkinson. Davis made a last second play, deflected it away. Fans wanted the penalty. I didn't see one there, Seamus. Wiggly with it. Bandoff's in the corner, he gets the ball. Back to Steve. Steve to Eskandarian. Voesmaer goes to the corner, Eske centers it in front. And there's Parkinson with the ball. And a whistle blows, and what's the call going to be?
Well, Alan Willie is down in the corner there, and he's been down for at least 30 seconds or so. I think he caught an elbow in the face there as Ricky Davis came away from the initial challenge. But it certainly didn't look like there was any intentional foul down there. Looks just like a challenge, a good, strong physical challenge. Peter Johnson checking with the goal judge, by the way, to see if there had been a foul there. The goal judge assured him there had not been. So now Willie is being treated by the trainer for Montreal.
Now, wait a minute, Seamus. Would a referee talk to a goal judge about a foul on the field?
Well, he just, he might very well ask him if he saw anything.
We did see him go over there, but I'm wondering, you know, whether he would have anything to say about that. I didn't mean to put you on the spot.
No,
I mean, from an informative point of view.
Well, we're taking another look at it here. You see the challenge by Ricky there.
That's not a foul.
No, that's not a foul. I think the foul happens here. That's where you see the finger in the face coming up. I think it was Eskandarian.
Yeah.
Just caught him with his
hand
in his eyes or just on his...
That was a foul. Cosmos fans, season tickets for the remaining 8 games of indoor soccer, the Cosmos way at the beautiful new Meadowlands Arena, are available now. Guarantee your family great seats for the rest of this action-packed season and for years to come. 7:30 p.m. kickoffs at all home games and quick and easy access into and out of the new arena makes Cosmos Indoor Soccer season tickets the ideal family gift this holiday season. Call 212-265-8600 for season and group sales information. Indoor soccer, the Cosmos way. Now there's Alan Woolley, who made his name with the Minnesota Kicks. Came over here to Montreal, did a fine job in the outdoor season. And Minnesota is no more. A drive by Escandirin. It looks to me, Seamus, as if the Cosmos coaches have told the defenders to get up there and whack it.
Well, it certainly is a good idea, given the fact that they haven't been doing that in some of the earlier matches, and the chances just simply have not been coming for them around the goal.
All right, Wegerle. And the forwards are positioning themselves in the box. And then the defenders, there is Escandirin blasting, and they figure if the forwards can get position, they can maybe knock in the rebound. Moyers trying to head it, and it's picked off by Rigby. Long throw by Riggs. Davis knocked it away from Chudin. Good defense by Ricky. Moyers is blasted from behind by Marc Antonio.
That's a third foul by Marc Antonio. I think Johnson's got over to warn him a little bit. He did get in very high and hard from behind on that one, and that's the third quite rough foul by Carmine. And Peter Johnson has not given any penalties out in this period with 12 minutes to go, but that one came close.
All right, here's Chinaglia. They go to Ricky Davis, and it's clear by Montreal. And Montreal, if they hurry, will have an advantage here. Escandirin fouled shooting just over the midfield line. Montreal puts it in play right away. Voesmaer, a little back heel for Fran O'Brien. Back to Chudin. Gets it over on the left foot, banks it in front. Davis has done a great job of knocking balls out of the slot, Seamus.
Well, Ricky fills in very nicely, just as Eske had been doing earlier. Eske that time got caught up a little bit on the foul, and Ricky very cleverly filled in behind him and stood right in front of Parkinson when that rebound came away. It's critical that you get between the goal and that center forward when the ball is coming off the boards.
Montreal and the Cosmos, one win and two defeats this year. Both clubs have had that one win at home. The Cosmos won big against Chicago 14-10. Montreal's win here was 2-1, Seamus.
Yeah, surprising score, 2-1 game with Toronto. And they had a bit of an embarrassment in Chicago where they lost 10-3 and did not look very good at all. They're hoping to redeem that performance tonight.
All right, Marc Antonio. Outside the line, there's no score in the game. 2:22 to play in the first period. This is Hayden Knight. They got him from Edmonton. He played indoor soccer with the NASL indoor champs last year. Edmonton beat Chicago for the title. Here comes Marc Antonio, blocked by Earhart Kapp. Here comes Earhart. Long ball, and that's a three-line pass in the air. Didn't touch anybody, and that's offside. We'll bring it back to the Cosmos line now and have a free kick for Montreal. Good shot of Bobby Rigby, Seamus.
Three-line pass, of course, as you pointed out, it did not play anybody, nor did it play a wall. If it comes off a wall before it crosses that third line, then it doesn't matter.
Give and go for Sutevsky just by. Good idea by Montreal. The shot by Hill is off the boards. Parkinson now got around two defenders, banks it in front, knocked away. Great save by Bursic. Great save by David Bursic. Sutevsky now looking to get it in front. Goes wide on the left for Hayden Knight. Ferdinando Di Matteo's playing him and now playing Hill. Ferdinando's playing everyone. Now Alberto gets on Sutevsky. Man free in front, knocked out of there by Kapp. And Di Matteo's with a foul. We talked about Bursic being a bright light. So has Earhart Kapp, Seamus.
I think so. Ferdy having a little bit of trouble there.
Hill blocked nicely by Marais, and a deflection just misses. Alberto trying to clear it nicely to Di Matteo's. Fernando has it stolen and now obstructs. A foul on Di Matteo's, obstructing Hayden Knight.
Well, Fernando Di Matteo's has been having his troubles in the last minute and a half defensively against Knight. He lost him a couple of times, and that time at the fouling.
Oh, another great Bursic save on Usian. And Montreal has been applying the pressure these last couple of minutes. And the referee says play on. And Bursic came out to take it off the foot of Usian. Long throw. Di Matteo's. Out fought Hayden Knight. And Knight knocked it away. Usian.
comes out for the Cosmos. On the right side, Sucheski and Brock. Goal! Gordon Hill, a goal. The game's first goal.
Well, Carlos Alberto had to leave his central position there to go over to take that threat on the right. As a result, Gordon Hill was able to slip in behind him in perfect position for the crossing pass. See, Carlos starts to go over now, and then Nelson Moraes knocked back quickly enough to close down Hill. Hill almost misses it, but then tucks it away.
And with 34 seconds remaining in the first period, Montreal has drawn first blood. That man, Gordon Hill, who was their outdoor top scorer, slots it, and it's 1-0 Montreal. Carlos toward the corner, but it's intercepted by Fandoff. Boris off the glass. Sutesky brings it under control in the corner.
That was Gordon Hill's fourth goal of the season. He has one assist, now has 9 points. And he puts Montreal on the board just before the end of this first period.
By Montreal on the wall. Cosmos completing a three-game road trip. It'll be great to be back in the Meadowlands, and they'll be there on the 29th, next Tuesday, against Jacksonville. Time remaining, no time. That's the end of the first period of play here in the Forum in Montreal. The Manic 1, the Cosmos nothing. You're watching Cosmos Indoor Soccer.
To all those viewers out there in Cosmos country, on behalf of myself, Rick Davis, and the rest of the Cosmos team and organization, we'd like to wish you a very beautiful and special Christmas and a happy new year.
We'll be back with more Cosmos Indoor.
Mark Franks.
Right at the Forum in Montreal, Jim Carvelis and Seamus Mallon, a look at the Cosmos bench, David Bursich, Giorgio Chinaglia. That's Errol Yassin there. Cosmos trail 1-0 on the goal by Hill with 34 seconds remaining in the first period, Seamus.
That was a well-taken goal by Montreal. Nice execution as they came down. The player wide right, that's Sutevsky, and he slots it right across to Hill. Hill getting in behind Nelson Moraes, who did not fill in quickly enough back on that left wing position. And Hill almost stepping on the ball, but recovered quickly enough to tuck it in. But a good pass from Usian to the right. Sutevsky, a quick, sharp cross ball, and Hill was there to knock it in. That goal at 14:26, Gordon Hill's fourth goal of the season, and the third assist of the season for Sutevsky. With three assists, believe it or not, he leads the Manic in assists. There is Gordon Hill. Gordon Hill, I think, is made for this game also, Jim, because he's such a good volleyer of the ball. He scored some great volleys outdoors, and this is a game in which volleying technique is very useful.
Seamus, Tuesday, January the 5th, is Cosmos T-shirt night. Cosmos meet Tulsa in a 7:30 p.m. start at the Byrne Meadowlands Arena, and the first 5,000 youngsters, 16 and under, will receive a complimentary Cosmos T-shirt. That's Tuesday, January the 5th, the Cosmos Youth T-shirt night. All right, to start the second period, it'll be Moyers, Chinaglia, G, Eskandarian, and Rick Davis, Bursich in goal, against Parkinson, Hill, Fran O'Brien, Voesmaer, Juremovic, with Rigby in goal. There's Bobby Rigby. Second period underway. O'Brien. Deflected by Giorgio. Moyer's got a foot on it. And it'll be Gerald G with the ball. G getting away. Nice pass to Moyers. Moyers ridden off the ball by O'Brien, but stays on. Eskandarian. Gerald G. Voesmaer clipping at his heels. Eski. A long ball to Hill. Davis goes to cover up. Gordon Hill, that devastating left foot. Off the mark by Parkinson. Bursich with it. Fires to Giorgio, back to Moyers. And the corner to Daryl G. Juremovic marking G. Now here's Rick Davis. Yuremovich broke it up. Hill didn't trap it very well. One in the air, though, by Yuremovich. Anyone's ball. And it belongs to Yuremovich. Montreal attacking. Parkinson got it to Hill. Off the boards, tries to tip it around Escondiri. Nothing doing. Eski up to Moyers. Hits by O'Brien. Voesmaer comes to take him on. Voesmaer got it back to Rigby.
Voesmaer, Jim, moved over very, very quickly there, reminiscent of his good sweeping play in the outdoors when he was voted best opponent by the Cosmos.
Ike Davis with the intercept. Chinaglia making the run. Davis took the shot. Rigby was trying to cross up Rigby. Rigby was watching Giorgio cut across the box. Rigby tried to sneak it by him. We'll see it. Deflected by Bandoff. Wegley on for the Cosmos. Good pass, Bandoff. 1-0 Montreal. 12:55 to play in the first half. Chinaglia in the box, trying to get Wegley.
Good ball to Steve. He's just not quite in there quickly enough, but very intelligent play by Giorgio, because up to now, when he's been given a pass like that, he's held it for a little bit, and of course, there he crossed him up a bit.
Fran O'Brien for Yuremovic, going with Escondiri in the corner. Yuremovic wins it, and a foul is going to be called. It's going to be, I believe, against Cosmos, against Escondiri. Free kick now. These are dangerous, Seamus, because they blast these in front, and they can go off anyone in the goal.
Exactly. Your defenders can hurt you here.
Put it on Usian's head, but the shot way over the top.
Well, Escondarian plays a very tough game indoors as he does outdoors. And here you see him coming in very hard on Yuremovic. Yuremovic staying well on the ball here, actually. He did win it back in the end. There's another challenge by Eski, pretty high and dangerous.
It's a three-line pass by the Cosmos. That's their second offside of the game. That'll be a free kick now for Montreal. Hill at the line. He can knock it in from here, by the way. Hill got around Bandoff. Escondiri finally cleared it. Bandoff trying to get it off the boards to Giorgio. Nothing doing. Hayden Knight was there. Now to Chinaglia. Goes cross field. They had to do that quickly, but Wegley didn't read it. Now Davis intercepts. Wegley to Davis at midfield. 12 minutes, 7 seconds to play in the first half. 1-0 Montreal. They scored 34 seconds before the end of the first period. Gordon Hill passes in front.
And it goes right through the goalkeeper and on goal. Mark Antonio trying to dribble it back to Rigby. Knocked it right through his legs. And the game is tied, Shannon.
Oh, dear, oh, dear, oh, dear. Montreal had worked so hard to get that goal before the end of the period. And now with just 3 minutes gone in the second period, they've given away a goal. And the Cosmos get a gift. Look at this. Mark Antonio has an easy touchback. And Rigby standing there with his legs wide open. Never expected. He thought he was going to be able to pick it up himself. Instead, he got a little touchback. And a little mistake like that. And these goal areas are so small. Before you know it, it's in the back of the net. 1-1.
Cosmos wish to acknowledge the continued support of LSA, the official outfitter of the Cosmos, and the Bahamas Princess Hotels, the official training center of the Cosmos, and of Joe Manfredi and Safe Toyota, the official automobile dealer of the Cosmos. Cosmos with a gift goal there and tied the game at 1. Own goal. Nelson Moraes. Hill still with the ball. Di Mateus and a whistle, and they're going to call foul on Montreal. Might have been either Mark Antonio or Hill.
Yeah, it was Hill. Mark Antonio, not the guilty party that time.
Fernando Di Mateus, kind of a Cinderella story. Tried out for the Cosmos. He's from Italy. Came over here, tried out for the Cosmos, and now getting a chance to play indoors. Earhart cap with a steal. Usian misplayed. Alberto. Carlos and now to Moraes, broken up by Sutevsky. Watch it. And a goal! Defensive mistake by the Cosmos, and Usian scores, and Montreal leads 2-1.
Bad mistake by Earhart Kapp there. Did not bring a ball very well under control. The initial mistake, however, made by out front by Moraes. Here you see Kapp just not bringing that ball under control. Usian easily gets around him, and no chance for David Bursic.
Usian took it well.
Yeah, took it very, very well. And a tough break there for Earhart Kapp.
That was a great move by Usian to get to his right and then fired in the corner. And it's 2-1 Montreal. Here's Alberto, a drive. Trying to blast it at the goal again. And it goes over the top. We have a goal kick coming up for Bobby Rigby. 11:10 to play. first half, 2-1 Montreal.
Lucien's first goal of the year, by the way. He had one assist before that, so he now has 3 points.
Cap muscling over there, trying to get away from Johnny Cantanas, another youngster, 19 years old. Cantanas has it. Alberto won it. Di Matteis to Cap to Moraes. To Giorgio. Crossfield to Carlos. Marc Antonio brilliantly headed away from Alberto, and Montreal with it. Here comes O'Brien. Cantanas is free. And a great save. Great save by Bursich. David Bursich came up big again, Seamus.
Great effort there by John Cantanas on that end. He got past Nelsie Moraes again. Nelsie not able to get back in time to shut him out. And a good volley in there by Cantanas on that ball. Came up on him. But David Bursich again saved the day. Look at this nice ball through. You see, not quite covered there by Nelsie, and a sliding save by Cantanas, by Bursich on Cantanas.
That was a great ball, Seamus. Here's Damir Sutkevski. He assisted on the first goal. This time Alberto steals and then gives it to Marc Antonio. Now to Sutkevski. 2-1 Montreal. Sutkevski into the fourth row. Cosmos and the Jacksonville T-Men. That'll be Tuesday, the 29th of December. The Meadowlands Arena. It'll be nice to get home, Seamus. That's a 7:30 start.
Well, it'll be good to see those T-men again. There's Eddie Firmani, a little bit more relieved now that his team has won back that very bad goal they've given away. Eddie right at the edge of the bench there, exhorting his troops.
Daryl G almost gave it away, and then Cosmos get it back. Out of Chinaglia. Giorgio, nice back heel to G. G to Giorgio. Chinaglia, Moyers, shot, missed. Davis, a blast, missed. Ball came out very hard. The glass is very live here, Seamus. The ball comes off that glass very hard. It's almost like a lively rim in basketball. And the Cosmos, when they hit that glass, kind of bunch up in front, but the ball goes over their head.
Yes, it's come off very, very quickly on them. And in previous arenas, it's been a rather slow backboard.
All right, here's Chinaglia. Cosmos trailing 2-1. G gets it in front, but it's cleared by Montreal. Here's Escandarian in midfield. Cantanas on him. Moyers, bad return to Esky. And here comes Montreal. Andy Parkinson plays it back to Sutkevski. And now to O'Brien at the Cosmos line. G marking O'Brien. Cantanas gave it away. Moyers, a nice return to Davis, just behind him a bit. Now Escandarian for Moyers. And the ball came lively off the boards again. It's not only the glass, it's the boards. Very lively here in Montreal. Here's Hill. Nice move and a goal! Gordon Hill. And that was a great one-on-one effort as he just beat David Bursich. A great move by Hill.
Well, he also beat Ricky Davis out front. Daryl G over on the right watching the pass, but it's a one-on-one situation. A little fake to the right. Ricky buys the fake, and he goes to that deadly left foot. Gordon Hill doing a great job on Ricky there. Here you see it again. Watch this now. He's going to take Ricky to Ricky's left. See the little fake there left? Ricky buys it, and he gives him that left foot, and that's not what you want to do for Gordon Hill.
3-1 Montreal. Wegerle. Handoff. Wegerle off the glass in front and tipped back to the goalkeeper. And the fans held their breath every time somebody gets it back to the goalkeeper. Tickets for all Cosmos home games available at the Cosmos Ticket Office, 75 Rockefeller Plaza. At the Byrne Meadowland Arena, at Ticketron, Charge It, Madison Square Garden, and branches of the Fidelity Union Banks and branches of the Manufacturers Hanover Trust Company. In front, cleared by Montreal. The Manic leads 3-1. And the foul's going to be called on Gordon Hill, fouling Rick Davis.
Ricky that time getting inside Gordon Hill very well, and Hill recoups that lost ground by fouling, but again, no penalty.
Wegerle to Chinaglia to Wegerle, bangs it, a shot saved. Nice save by Rigby. Tough angle, but Wegerle had a lot on it. Hayden Knight is pushing off. Hayden Knight is pushing off, and the Cosmos will get a free kick. Time remaining 7:34, Seamus, in the first half.
Well, that was Gordon Hill's second goal of the night, his fifth goal of the season. And the assists were by O'Brien and Sutevsky. That's Sutevsky's second assist of the night and his fourth of the season. So he's leading, still leading the team, obviously. And Fran O'Brien picks up an assist to add to his one.
Regularly trying to lift it in the box, but it was stolen by Voesmaer. Here comes Hayden Knight. They've got Voesmaer and Hill. It's a 3-on-2. Voesmaer. Push it off, and Hill misses the open net. Tough angle, but he misses the corner. 3-1 Montreal. 7 minutes to play and a half. Rick Davis at his own line. Escandarian. Davis in midfield. Chinaglia to Bandoff. Giorgio trying to come in his trip. No penalty. I think it was a penalty anyway. Went through the legs of Hayden Knight. Ricky Davis takes him out in the corner and stole the ball. Nice distribution outside the Bandoff, sets the Cosmos running. Bandoff to Giorgio, knocked away by Yuremovic. Eski now to Di Matteis. Back to Eski, to Giorgio off the boards, a follow by Di Matteis, and a good save by Bobby Rigby.
Smart shot by Giorgio there, no chance to go for goal. He whacked it off the board. Di Matteis read it well, cut in, but was just harassed enough by Parkinson. Now there's Di Matteis giving the ball to Eski, and now to Giorgio, and Giorgio with a shot. Now watch Di Matteis come in. He's hassled just a little bit by Parkinson. See the little push there. Murphy doesn't call anything, and the chance is gone.
All right, we're back to the live action. Yuremovic at the Cosmos line. 3-1 Montreal. 5:50 to play in a half. Jim Carvelis, Seamus Mellon. Here come the Cosmos 2-on-1. To Di Matteis. To Giorgio. Shot blocked by Voesmaer. Good defensive play by Voesmaer. Di Matteis battling in the corner. Gets it in front, but Rigby smothered it.
Good chance there for the Cosmos. Two against one. You don't get that often, but Bobby Voesmaer played it very, very well and blocked the second attempt by Giorgio.
So two goals by Gordon Hill, one by Usian. And Montreal leads 3-1. The Cosmos goal was an own goal. Montreal knocked it in their own net. Marc Antonio trying to roll it back to Rigby, knocked it through his legs. And the Manic with 5:15, a play and a half lead, 3-1. Well, we tell you the Bursts has had a great year, despite the fact that the Cosmos haven't played great yet in the indoor, except the first game. And Seamus going to be talking to David Bursts at halftime. Here comes Hill. Looking for the hat trick, and it just went by. Bursic's got a foot on it, and it just rolled past the goal line. Alberto, good ball to Giorgio. Moyers going in front. Chinaglia lost the ball to Marc Antonio. To Usian, over the midfield line. He's got O'Brien on the left, he's got Hill on the right. O'Brien's one-on-one, and another good save by Bursic. Montreal's getting some chances here, Seamus.
Hill hit the crossbar. And the Cosmos having a lot of trouble with their, if you can call it, back-checking. I guess that's almost what it is. Players go forward, they're just simply not getting back quickly enough. And Nelson Moraes again having trouble getting back. And that was his man, O'Brien, who got free on the left. But what a terrific little flip there by Hill as he set himself up for the volley.
Hi, Moraes gets free now. Hayden Knight comes back to pick him up. Knight has very good speed. Now Cap back to Moraes. Nelsie, the Earhart Cap, he heads it toward the goal. Easy for Rigby. Alan Willian, by the way, Seamus, for the first time since he was injured in that first period. Now this is Usia. Willie coming forward and Hayden Knight with him. Cosmos back, shot blocked by Alberto. Moyers picks it up at the right boards. That ball really shot off the boards. Now Moyers picks it off. Now intercepted by Sutevsky. This is Hayden Knight. Bad pass intended for Willie in the box. Picked off by Earhart Kapp. Chinaglia. Giorgio intercepts. There's Chinaglia over the midfield line. Quick pass to Moyers in the corner. Moyers now wheeling. Nice move. Shot! Missed by Moyers. What a shot by Steve Moyers. Alberto a drive. Almost trapped down by Chinaglia. Couldn't control it in the box. Moyers. Usian came over to double team and take it away.
That was a great
ball. Marc Antonio. 2-on-1. Willie. He missed it. really did not hit that very well. Couldn't get his steps together, Sheamus. Give and go. Usyk all alone, another save. And Alberto clears it. I'll tell you, Firsich has had to make at least 7 one-on-one saves. Now for Gerald G. G has it, and what a play by Sheamus to block the shot. Usyk. And Weggley hustle back to knock it away. Time remaining 2:45. Sheamus in the half, 3-1 Montreal.
Good defensive play by Weggley there, but that's what the Cosmos need a bit more of. They're allowing far too many players going forward into attacking positions without being checked or closed down.
Right, Davis with the ball. Now it's Esky. Off the boards, Weggley trying to sneak it in. Marc Antonio banks it to Parkinson. And a slot to Chinaglia. Unbelievable. Marc Antonio gave it to Giorgio, and Rigby denied him.
Giorgio not realizing, I guess, how much space and room he had there. He could have turned around and just touched that one in.
All right, Parkinson with the ball. Nice tackle. Eskandarian won the ball from Andy Parkinson. Here's Davis. G's on the right. And this is Weggley and Chinaglia on the left. Giorgio to Davis. He missed his shot. Good setup by Giorgio. Rigby now in the corner. In front, Weggley, go!
Good hard work by Rigby Davis there, paid off. Darryl G also scrapping. They got some scrappers out there. Weggley a scrapper, and that's gotten them back into it. Weggley finally seizes on it, and just drills it beautifully. Just impossible for Rigby to get down fast enough to do much more than touch it, and that brings the Cosmos back into the game a little bit.
Remember, fan, the Cosmos return home to the Meadowlands Arena Tuesday night for a holiday week game against the Jacksonville team. And at 7:30 p.m. next Tuesday, December the 29th, the Cosmos and the T-Men. They beat the Cosmos 6-4 in Jacksonville, so they'll have some evening up to do. All right, here comes Sutevsky, 3-2 Montreal. Firsich has just been brilliant in the goal. Even though the Cosmos are losing, he's made some great saves. One-on-one. Sheamus, I think, at least 6 or 7 times. He's had to take the man all by himself.
He sure has. He's had... There's Errol Yassin chewing very hard on that gum. And Mauro, the assistant coach in there, I think it's important that they get that goal. They're now down 3-2. There's a minute 24 to go. But if the Cosmos had gone in down 2 goals, then I think they would have been pretty dispirited. But now they're back within a goal, and if they can just consolidate this situation or even add to it before the quarter, they'll be in excellent shape.
All right, Cosmos. Bandoff knocked it in the corner for Giorgio. But knocked away by Yuremovich. Now O'Brien... the ball, Di Matteis knocked it away. Alberto to Giorgio to Ferdinando, but again it's Yuremovic to pick it off.
Incredible, they've given no assist on that goal, and obviously Rigby Davis played that ball beautifully out of the corner.
Absolutely.
I don't understand why he hasn't gotten an assist. It was an excellent pass.
Moyers at the line, the midfield line. Lead nicely for Bandoff. Now to Giorgio, good play by Sutevsky. Just got a foot on it. Cosmos trying to tie the game with 39 seconds and a half. And a drive by Cap. A follow by Moyers. He ran into Chinaglia in the slot. Both going for the ball. Now Sutevsky comes out. To Fran O'Brien, a counterattack with 27 seconds. Sutevsky off Carlos Alberto in the slot. Moyers. And it's intercepted. And Parkinson knocked by Alberto onto the slot again. 15 seconds. And now this is Giorgio. In front, knocked out of there by O'Brien. Bandoff and Yuremovich. And it's cleared out to Sutevsky with 1 second. And that's it. So the Cosmos close the gap to 3-2. As the veteran Carlos Alberto, who has blocked at least 6 or 7 shots tonight, walks off for a well-deserved halftime rest. At halftime in Montreal, Montreal's Monty 3, the Cosmos 2. You're watching Cosmos Indoor Soccer.
Keeper for the Cosmos. That's it. Starting goalkeeper, David. That must be music to your ears. What about the challenge of this, though? This really puts you on the spot. Are you eager for it?
I'm very eager, and I've enjoyed it very much so far. It's been a good experience for myself. I feel good, and I think only better things will happen in the future.
Well, a lot of responsibility must fall on your shoulders, not just because the indoor game has so much activity around the goal, but because there are very few people whom you can imitate. There are no role models in indoor soccer.
No, there aren't really. I do believe that the Shep Messing, being the goalkeeper who has played the sport the longest, has given everyone a little bit to look for in what he does. But basically, you know, I'm not the same type of goalkeeper he is, so I can't really model myself after him. I have to do what I think I can do best and in the different situations that this game presents itself.
Well, let's talk about your style of play. Obviously, you've had to adapt it from the outdoor game because it's not the same sport at all. Do you feel more reluctance to come out from the goal, for instance?
I don't feel any reluctance. I wish, I think in the future I'll become more comfortable with coming out. I think a goalkeeper can really be a sixth defender and a sixth offensive player also. And I think once we play this game a little bit longer, I'll be able to understand that role in this game.
Well, the obvious key difference, though, the one that must give you nightmares, is the presence of those boards. When you're in the outdoor game, can relax when a shot goes by the post. There's no relaxing in this game at all. How do you prepare for this?
You don't really prepare, of course. You just try to be ready for the shot. And when you feel that it's by you, you have to leave it. And there are some times where it's more advantageous to go for the ball and try to knock it away into the corner. But then if you do miss and it goes off the boards, then you're in serious trouble. So you just have to know, you know, who's in front of you and what's around you, and when the ball hits the boards, it'll be prepared for it.
Well, there are also an awful lot of players lurking around that area looking for the quick touch-in. Do you find that, therefore, there's a greater risk of injury from players, never mind the boards?
I don't really feel so. I think if you give up a lot of rebounds, then you can present yourself with injury problems. If you drop the ball and then you're scrambling for it, that's where your injuries come. I think if the shot comes and you knock it away or you hold on to it, then you don't have people sticking their foots in your face and you don't have that problem.
Well, you also have the added advantage now of being able to get on the score sheet because of the distribution role a goalkeeper has in this game. You have a chance for getting assists. Are you practicing on any special techniques in distribution?
The main idea is to see the striker, to understand the understanding between the striker and the goalkeeper and try to give the ball to him. That's your main target man. And if you can work out something special where that man can get free and you can feed it over the defender's head or something, then it's a great situation. But otherwise, you give it to the second man, and he can, of course, play with the striker. I think the goalkeeper's most assists will come as a second assist, not as a first.
The indoor game, of course, has limited applicability in the outside. You don't see a lot of those high swerving crosses that you get from those clever players such as in Chicago, Sting, and some of the other teams. Do you fear in any way that you may lose that skill indoors?
I don't believe so. I've played long enough now that, if we weren't playing the indoor, we'd be playing, you know, we'd be in the off season, so we wouldn't be playing anyway. So I don't see it as a big problem.
And you don't think that the emphasis on getting down to the ground as much is in any way going to slow you down afterwards?
No, I think it'll help. Basically, being a taller person and with longer legs or whatever, the lower ball has always been a little more difficult for me. So if anything, I think the game will help me.
Well, now you're one of the young Americans on this team, and do you agree with the others I've spoken to that this is a great opportunity for you, or do you sense it's a bit of a tough expectation?
Well, I think it's excellent. I think basically for a lot of the players, who, especially the rookies and the first-year players, it gives them the idea what professional sports is all about and competition, weekly competition on a professional level, and that's something that we're all here to do.
Well, Dave Bursich is a professional player, the number one goalkeeper for the indoor Cosmos. We'll be back with more Cosmos action after this message.
Belong to the Montreal Canadiens. But tonight, it's the site of an indoor game between the Cosmos and the Montreal Manic. By the way, because you do see a couple of empty seats there, this has been a terrible day in Montreal. It's been snowing all day. In fact, when we landed today at the airport, I was amazed we got in. Our director, Elliot Terrell's plane, slid off the runway. So it's been a very tough day, but 6,000 or 7,000 people have braved the elements, Seamus, to see two clubs that have always gone after each other the way they've gone after each other in the first half here. It's time now for our Budweiser NASL halftime report, Seamus.
Well, I think we're going to see a surprise when we look at the Eastern Division. And the surprise, of course, is that Toronto is in first place. Toronto, having had trouble in the outdoor game, has done pretty well indoor. They haven't lost their most recent game. The Cosmos in Montreal, you see, tied up there in second place. And Jacksonville, with that 1-3 record, Jacksonville, as usual, knocking the Cosmos off and then struggling with the other clubs. They come in to Cosmos country next on the 29th, so that'll be a chance for the Cosmos to get sweet revenge on them. But that division is still very much wide open. Of course, the winner goes right on to the playoffs, so it's important to try to wrap up the title if you can.
Shane, it's also interesting as we take a look now at the Central Division to note that in the indoor game, we don't have points or bonus points. It's like baseball. You know, teams are a game out, a game and a half out, two out. And Tulsa, I'm told, Seamus, by many people, it could be the top two or three, one of the top two or three teams indoor in the league.
I think so. They started practicing much earlier than anybody else. They lost one game, but they've won four in a row.
To Chicago.
And that's right. And they'll be in into the Meadowlands again right after Jacksonville.
As far as the Pacific Conference is concerned, real dogfight going on over there also, Seamus, with Seattle on top, 4-3, Edmonton 3-2, Vancouver 3-2, so no one's under 500 in that division, the Northwest Division.
Seattle is going to be tough, I think. They played a lot of games already, so they're almost halfway through their schedule. Those three losses may hurt them this early, but they've looked very strong, got some good scorers up there. Some familiar names we'll be talking about shortly.
All right, the Western Division, three teams there. San Jose on top, and then comes Portland and San Diego. You know, it's dawned on me that four of the divisional leaders were not on top of their divisions in the outdoor game. Toronto was in last place. Tulsa was, I think, the second or third place team in their division. Seattle was the third place team, and San Jose, I believe, was in the basement or close to it in the West. But they've found life in the indoor game, Seamus.
San Diego, surprising, they're struggling with the 1-4 record. I would have expected a little bit better things from them.
All right, in the early stages of the season, as far as the leading scorers are concerned, keep in mind also that some of these players have played quite a few games. For instance, Edmonton's played five games, and they have the top scorer in the league, and Jan Gusens, who has really done a number, 38 points in five games. It's an average of over three goals a game and one assist a game.
And Julie V coming close behind him. They're also playing five games now. Davies and Hudson at Seattle have played seven games, of course, so their points are really boosted by that. And you see nobody from the Cosmos there. They've only played three games. Giorgio is leading scorer with 17 points.
All right, here's a look at Jeff Durgan, who we did not see in that first half, Seamus. No word on Jeff. But I did notice that he did come on the field with warm-ups before the game as well, so he may have been injured a bit before the game. All right, we'll be back with the second half. You're watching Cosmos Indoor Soccer.
You prosper, I don't know. I wish for the Cosmos fans, for the American people, and for everybody who's living this country, Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
To you, Carlos, and it's nice to have you back. And all of you out there, by the way, a happy holiday season. Whether it be Merry Christmas or Happy Hanukkah. Cosmos will be at the Meadowlands on the 29th. It'll be nice to be home, Seamus. Three tough road games. Jacksonville.
Real
and
nice.
Then Toronto, and now here Montreal. It's a great city, though, Seamus.
Real nice to go home 2-2 as opposed to 1-3. This game is here to be won, I sense, more so than the Toronto game, when the Cosmos did not look sharp.
3-2, Montreal on top. We start the second half with Davis and Chinaglia and G and Moyers and Escandarian. All right, that's Daryl G with the ball. Juremovic is on him. Hill is on for Montreal. Parkinson, O'Brien, and Voesmaer. Rigby in the goal for Montreal and David Bursich for the Cosmos. Hill has scored twice in the first half. Usian scored the other. The Cosmos benefited from an own goal and then a Steve Wegerle goal. And that's where we're at right now. 3-2. The second half is 45 seconds old. G lets O'Brien get around. And a goal!
kick for O'Brien as Darryl G allowed O'Brien to move around him on the boards and set up Hill.
Again, that lethal left foot of Gordon Hill. Watch him take this ball beautifully on his left foot and strike it right into the corner off the inside of the post. Darryl G challenging for that ball against O'Brien in the corner. Really went in off balance and the tackle gave, therefore, O'Brien the chance to move in. He took it beautifully, slipped it to Hill, and Hill makes no mistake with that left foot.
Well, it took Montreal 54 seconds to put another goal on the scoreboard, and David Bursich doesn't feel very good about that, but he could do nothing about it. Now Escondarian for the Cosmos, down 42. Darryl G. He's battling with O'Brien. G bangs it off the boards right to Rigby. Long throw by Rigby, and it's Davis easily for the Cosmos. Cosmos would like to announce the formation of the Cosmos Kickers, a fan club for all Cosmos fans 16 and under. Each new member receives an official Cosmos Kicker t-shirt, an official Cosmos Kicker lapel pin, an official Cosmos Kicker decal kit, an indoor team picture. Best of all, coupons good for a ticket at two special Cosmos Kicker nights at the arena. The first Cosmos Kicker night is January the 9th when the Cosmos take on Jacksonville. And the second Cosmos Kicker night is Saturday, February the 6th when the Cosmos meet a great rival for them, Tampa Bay's Rowdies. It costs membership only $5, so don't delay. Join now. Call the Cosmos office for further information. Rigby fires to Hill. Gordon Hill's got three goals. And the Cosmos trail 4-2. Early stages, second half. Jim Carvelis and Seamus Mallon from the Forum in Montreal. Hayden Knight is obstructed and knocked down by Moyers. We have not had a penalty in this game.
No, and not really anything close to it. A couple of occasions there were some fouls that might have been called, but so far Peter Johnson, I think, has done a very good job.
DeMatteis for the Cosmos coming to the Montreal line. To Chinaglia, bangs it for Cap in the corner. The ball bounced off Lively again, and it was misread by Cap, and here comes Hayden Knight, a speedster. Cosmos clear it. Here comes Eske. Back to Bandoff. Here's Boris Bandoff attacking for the Cosmos. Out to Eske. Outside the box. Eske's left-footed shot knocked down by Voesmaer. Eske thought DeMatteis was going to go in the corner, and he didn't. Rigby threw it over the head of Cap and Hill. Bursich out of his goal, fires good ball to DeMatteis, and Voesmaer took it away. Nice play by Bandoff to strip Voesmaer of the ball. Now to Carlos Alberto. Carlos. Bandoff. DeMatteis in the slot. Shot easy for Rigby. He saw it all the way. Cap is on Hill. Great pass by Hill. Yuremovich in the right corner. And a drive. Deflected off the crossbar and a save by Bursich.
Terrific play there again by Montreal, playing it wide and then crashing in on goal from wide positions. David reacting very quickly to that second shot, otherwise it might have slipped by him. His distribution pass, however, not good. Gave it right back to Montreal when the Cosmos had a good chance for a two against one break.
Hill, a great pass to Usian and a courageous play by Bursich, who came out to challenge the man. What a pass by Hill. Bandoff to Alberto. Good ball to Wegerle, who leaves it back. Now Carlos gets it back to him in the corner.
Oh, unfortunate for Steve to have done that. Wegerle dropping that ball back. He might have tried to run on with it or turn his man around.
All right, Usian trying to pass it to himself off the boards. Here's Chinaglia. Good pass to Wegerle. Headed away by Rigby. Nice play by Riggs. Now Bandoff coming. Knocked away by Sutevsky. And now it's Montreal on the attack. Damir Sutevsky and a drive and a save by Bursich with 10:25 to play in the third period. 4-2 Montreal over the Cosmos. One of these clubs will be 500 when the night is over. The other will be 200. Cosmos scrapping, but O'Brien still on the ball. And to himself. Nice play by Fran O'Brien. Alberto stole it. And Ricky Davis inadvertently off the side of his foot battles Usian, and Usian is fouled by Rick Davis.
Well, Carlos made another one of those patented steals of his and played the ball very smartly out to Ricky, but Ricky just couldn't quite get out of the way of that ball coming off his heel. Otherwise, it was a good attack.
O'Brien free, Alberto blocks. Chinaglia got his foot up high. Marc Antonio got it to in the slot that Willie had a lot of little bit of room. He didn't know it. He laid it off. Cosmos have it. Chinaglia with Sutevsky, Alberto, and Moyers running. Here comes Moyers. Shot and a goal! Moyers. Chinaglia started that play beautifully with a pass to the right, and Moyers took it very well, Seamus, as he hit the left-hand corner.
Beautifully taken by Moyers. A good quick pass from Carlos Alberto, and then touched on to Giorgio. Carlos Alberto drawing some attention in the middle. There you see the pass from Carlos, or rather from Giorgio, as Carlos goes down the middle, and Moyers cuts in very well, uses the players in front as a decoy, and then slams it into the far corner. And again, Rigby can't quite get down fast enough for that, so the Cosmos are once again are back in within one goal. They're down 4-3
with 9:25 to play in the third period, and a typical Montreal Cosmos soccer game, indoor or outdoor. It's usually a one-goal game. It's always been a one-goal game. To Durgan, over to Ricky Davis inside the line, attacking Montreal. There's Moyers. Chinaglia's shot saved by Rigby. Long lead. Escandarian did well to knock it away, but it's Fran O'Brien with it. Usian's in the corner. Bangs it off the boards. There's Moyers. Steve Moyers with Usian on him. And under pressure, knock it into the Montreal bench. Montreal's ball. Badly taken, Davis intercept. Chinaglia up the right boards with Carmine Marcantonio. Giorgio overran the ball. Cleared by Durgan, on for the first time tonight, Seamus.
Good to see Jeff out there. I wondered about him. He does have a tape on his right ankle, it looks like. Maybe not, but maybe just the white sock.
Bad pass by the Cosmos, put him under pressure, and now Durgan slamming Parkinson into the boards, and it'll be a free kick for Montreal.
I thought Jeff might have had some wrapping on there on his ankle, but he doesn't.
Moyers battling. Boy, he's a scrapper. Steve Moyers. Good pass to Giorgio. Giorgio back to Rick Davis in the corner, shielding Sutevsky. Rick now getting it for Giorgio. Giorgio battling, lost the ball. O'Brien doing a great job getting away from two Cosmos, playing it over to Parkinson. O'Brien in the slot, one pass too many. Pass for Chinaglia, not a good pass. Marc Antonio picked it off. Here comes Andy Parkinson with 7:34 in the third period, 4-3 Montreal. David Bursich with the ball. 7:15 to play, third period. Escandarian. Giorgio. Daryl G comes on. Daryl G. Giorgio trying to turn. Good play by Marc Antonio. He's done a good job marketing him, Seamus. Esky. Wegele. He has scored a goal tonight. Esky, a shot that's deflected and controlled and cleared by Andy Parkinson, knocked back in by Durgan. Marc Antonio with it. Now to Gordon Hill. Durgan will pick him up on the boards. Hill, great ball control, great skill. Now to O'Brien. G marking him, deflected by Esky in the slot. Banged in front. Hill again, and it's 5-3 Montreal, and four goals for Gordon Hill.
Well, every time the Cosmos get close, they seem to do something that puts them in a hole again. Parkinson there in front, knocks it in front. Jeff Durgan coming over, but does not get a good position in time on Gordon Hill, in much the way that Ricky Davis and Esky had been able to get good position in the first period. Jeff arriving just a split second too late, and a split second too late in this game means a goal.
Cosmos Cosmos just haven't been able to get over the hill tonight. They trail 1-0, then they cut it on an own goal 1-1. Then it was Montreal 2-1, Montreal 3-1. Then the Cosmos closed it to 3-2. Montreal made it 4-2 at the start of the second half. There's a pass in front that's cleared away from Chinaglia, Di Matteis. Then the Cosmos made it 4-3 and a Moyers goal, but now Hill again makes it 5-3. G's shot is knocked down by Voesmaer. 6 minutes to play in the third period. Montreal by 2-5-3. Tap to Di Matteis. Gets away from the tackle by Hayden Knight. Fernando Di Matteis. Now a good ball to G in the corner. G to Voesmaer. Slides it in front, nobody there. Look at that ball jump off the board, Seamus. And here comes Usian. Usian. Hayden Knight is on with him. The shot deflected. Comes in, a shot and a miss by Usian. A great chance. Now it's Cap hitting the ankle by Usian. Cap is back up.
Well, Cap had got an excellent position there and got the ball away, and Usian just whacked him in the leg as he did. I don't think intentionally at all, but
no, it wasn't. No, I think he was taking the shot.
Yep.
Cosmos have Alberto, Cap, Di Matteis, Chinaglia, and G. They clear it. Montreal with Voesmaer, Yuremovich, Hayden Knight, Usian, and Hill. Going for Hill, but it was deflected. Alberto chips it out, but it's intercepted by Hayden Knight. Montreal dominating here now, Seamus, leading by two and with the ball. Cosmos win it. And that was Yuremovich holding Daryl G.
Well, it seems that the Montreal Manic need for the Cosmos to pull within one goal of them every time in order for them to come out and start playing spirited stuff. When they're ahead by two goals, they really are a little bit lackadaisical and not quite as disciplined. But when they get close, they really start to work.
Vandoff to Chinaglia, off the boards in front, and Vandoff could not slot it home. That was a good pass. Alberto intercepts to Vandoff. Boris couldn't control it well enough, and Montreal reacquires. Here's Voesmaer. Intercepted almost over the foot of Alberto. Now Carlos got it back again. Now to Vandoff. Carlos Alberto. Knocked down by Usian. The referee says play on. There's that man Hill again in the slot. Nobody there. Hayden Knight. Alberto knocked it out. Good clearing pass by Cap to Vandoff. Cosmos on a 2-on-2 break. Now they come up to make it 4-on-2. Moyers. Vandoff free. Chinaglia miss. Vandoff had a great shot and he went cross field with it, Seamus.
I don't know why. Boris had a great chance to put one in there and he instead gave away a rather difficult pass to Chinaglia.
Now to Moyers. Montreal 5, the Cosmos 3. 3:45 to play third period. Moyers shot blocked by Voesmaer. He blocks a lot of shots. And now to Alberto. Remember, the Cosmos returned home to the Meadowlands Arena Tuesday night for a holiday week game against the Jacksonville team at 7:30. That's next Tuesday, December 29th. The Cosmos and the T-Man. Chinaglia heads to the boards. Durgan off the boards, but it's cleared by Voesmaer. A tower on defense.
He's terrific.
As he's been in the outdoor
game. Here he is going forward. What a good pass.
Handoff. Couldn't break it up. And a great save. Persich clears it. Voesmaer. 5-3 Montreal. Blocked by Durgan in the slot. Vandoff did not pass it very well to get the Cosmos out of the zone. So O'Brien has for Montreal. O'Brien on the right boards to Alan Woolley. Woolley tries to get it to Parkinson in the slot, but Durgan intercepted. Woolley got it right back, and Parkinson was unmarked in the slot. Lucky the Cosmos for the Cosmos that the ball went by. But Durgan had to go in the corner to take the man, Seamus. And the Cosmos aren't reading each other defensively.
Well, he didn't hold him in there either.
Giorgio trying to get it back to Rick Davis, deflected away. Now Moyers controlling right edge of the box. His pass deflected. Davis hit it into the upper deck.
What I mean by Jeff Durgan going to the corner there, he not only lost the ball, but he did not really do a strong enough defensive play on his man. I don't mean illegally holding him, but certainly getting him in a position where he couldn't dribble around him. So having committed himself to the corner, he didn't delay the player long enough, and nobody had covered up behind him.
All right, there's Bursich coming out of his own goal. Nobody in front, but Durgan as he knocked it away. O'Brien blocked by Durgan. Alan Woolley, Montreal applies pressure with a minute 57 to play third period. Sutevsky got it off to Woolley. In front, Durgan tipped it out. Davis has it back to Wesky. Escondarian with a minute 45. Bounces off the boards, Wegerle. Woolley's tackled it away. Now they get it to Fran O'Brien. To Woolley. Back to O'Brien. Good play by Escondarian to get in the way of the shot. Here comes Esky. O'Brien knocked it away. Esky controls to Wegerle. Plays it back for Davis. A minute 17 in the third period. The Cosmos trail 5-3. Durgan bangs it in the corner. Sutevsky is there to play it. And here's O'Brien. Esky won it and then gave it away.
Oh, great chance by Esky there. There were three players forward for the Cosmos, pulling all the Montreal players out of position.
Bursich got it to Davis, got it to Escondarian. Under a minute to play in the third period. DeMatteis out for the Cosmos. Goes to the corner, has it tackled away. Lucia. And they call a foul on Fernando DeMatteis.
I disagree with that call. Lucien, as he made his spin to his left, I thought clearly leaned into DeMatteis. They certainly came together. Lucien was on the ball, but I thought he whacked into DeMatteis. Let's see him now. He turns around. Let's see if he does here. Yeah, I think he leaned into him. His elbow went out. They both leaned into each other, perhaps. And the referee goes with the attacker there.
Chinaglia heading it toward DeMatteis. Sutevsky got up over the top and fouled DeMatteis with 21 seconds to play in the third period. Damir Sutevsky, veteran defender. It's a good job for this club, Seamus, in the outdoor. All right, here's Hayden Knight off the defending NASL champion Edmonton Drillers into the crowd. It'll belong to Montreal with 3 seconds, and Eddie Firmani is feeling pretty good about things right now. His club leading the Cosmos by two. There's the time, 3 seconds. That's it. That's the end of the third period in Montreal, and the score, 5 for Montreal, 3 for the Cosmos. You're watching Cosmos Indoor Soccer.
Holiday greetings from Budweiser. The people who bring you Budweiser wish you and yours a happy and safe holiday season.
Hi.
Your breath. You forgot your Lister Mint mouthwash.
Hi. Meet our new neighbors.
Hello there. The pleasure is all mine.
Sure wasn't theirs.
This could shatter a guy's confidence.
Get up your Lister Mint and get up your confidence.
Lister Mint is confidence. It has natural mint and is more effective than the leading mint mouthwash.
I'm confident we'll be friends.
Well. Hi. Get up your Lister Mint and get up.
1850 Coney Island Avenue in Brooklyn, the home of Joe Manfredi's Safe Toyota, featuring the Toyotas for 1982. Let Joe Manfredi and his staff introduce you to the Toyota Quality Advantage, the complete line of Celicas, Corollas, trucks, and Starlet, the highest mileage Toyota. Joe Manfredi's Safe Toyota has built a reputation of service after the sale, and that's why customers come back year after year. See for yourself, Joe Manfredi's Safe Toyota, 1850 Coney Island Avenue in Brooklyn.
Hi, this is Jeff Durgan of the Cosmos, wishing all of you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
All right, the Cosmos bench here as they get ready for the fourth period. Down by two. 5-3, Seamus. David Bursich looks a little tired there. He's had a lot of work in the first three periods.
He sure had, and Again, I think the Cosmos had the best start to any game they played all season, with even including Chicago, because keep in mind, against Chicago, they were down 2-0 before they could really get going. But in the last couple of games, they've not played with as much kind of fluidity as they did in that first 5 minutes or so. There you see Errol trying to give some instructions on how to play this game. Steve Moyers got a very fine goal for the Cosmos, the third goal, and it looked like it was going to really help him get close. Here you see him just getting the ball in a nice wide pass and going to the far post, which is what all coaches want players to do as they come in from the right or left side. Don't go for that near post, go for the far post. Well, indoor soccer, the Cosmos way, returns to the Meadowlands Arena next Tuesday night, December 29th at 7:30 p.m. when the Cosmos hosts the Jacksonville T-Men. Make the new craze of Cosmos indoor soccer the highlight of your Christmas vacation week. That's the Cosmos and the T-Men in the easily accessible Meadowlands Arena on Tuesday night, December 29th at 7:30 p.m.
All right, down to the Cosmos of the fourth period. DeMatteis, G, Moyers, Durgan, and Eskandarian for the Cosmos. Bursic in the goal against Chudin from Montreal. Alan Woolley, Carmine Marcantonio, Damir Satevsky, and Hayden Knight, Bob Rigby in the goal. Satevsky back to Hayden Knight for the final 15 minutes of regulation. Four 15-minute quarters in indoor soccer. Marcantonio back to the goalkeeper, Bob Rigby. That pass was intended for Hayden Knight, but it slipped through to Woolley. Nicely to Knight, trying to get it back to Woolley. Durgan cannot take it away. Woolley to Chudin. DeMatteis hustles it away. Good play by Ferdinando. That is Steve Moyers. Moyers got a foot on it. Eskandarian cannot handle it. Now Eski's got it, and he drove it into the crowd. You gotta like Moyers because he really works. Well, this man always works, Eskandarian.
That was a good effort by Eski. He nipped in very adroitly there and stole the ball and sort of skipped along the top of the glass and then came his way, and he just hammered it first time with the right foot in the half volley. It just got under it a bit too much. But a good effort by Eski, who hasn't scored this season.
All right, toward DeMatteis, but it's picked off. Fans thought that Eski should have had a foul following shooting. Pretty knowledgeable fans here in Montreal, Seamus. Good soccer fans. We have a crowd of about 7,000, I would imagine. Terrible weather conditions here in Montreal. Moyers. Now for Daryl G in the corner. Watch Daryl. And a good defensive play by Marcantonio. Shooting. Good pass for Hayden Knight. Coming to Cosmos zone. Durgan went after the ball. Bursic tipped it away. And a header by Judith. And Montreal leads 6-3.
Well, the Cosmos defense under a great strife there, because once again the wingers did not get back. You see Willie all alone out there, and tough chance for David. He did well to just flick it away, but those little flicks that go over the end line normally.
You see Chester right there. Durgan had two men on him.
That's right.
Went for the ball.
He had two men on him because the winger on that left side, who in this case was DeMatteis, just simply did not get back, did not check back fast enough. And that created a two-on-one situation. This game, you simply cannot afford to relax and stay upfield. You have to come back all the time.
Cosmos have new players now. It's Alberto and Cap and Vandoff, Chinaglia and Wegley. A hard drive. That was some shot by Cap, and a good save by Bobby Rigby. Long pass for Hill in the corner. Alberto covers. Hill. Broken up by Cap. Now O'Brien and Sutevsky. And Montreal with a 6-3 lead and attacking. Band off to Giorgio. Marcantonio is shadow. They knock it away. Now Hill. Intercepted by Cap. Good pass to Wegley. Good pass to Bandoff. Over the line, the Cosmos attack. Now Cap in the slot. Chinaglia, shot and a goal. Wendling. And it's 6-4 now. Montreal with 12-24. Two goals for Steve Wendling.
Again, the secret of that goal was the speed with which the Cosmos moved it forward. Boris Pandoff did not dribble it too much. You see, he takes one dribble. Now he's going to play the ball quickly to his left. And then the defender collapses on Cap. But Giorgio is about to score here, really, until he's bowled over by O'Brien, and the ball runs loose to Wegerle. The defense having drifted right to left, Wegerle, of course, was then open on the right side.
All right, it's 6-4 Montreal now, with 12-20 to play in the ball game, in regulation. Voesmaer back on defense now for Montreal. Moyers chases him. Ricky Davis intercepts. Good play there by Yaremovic to knock it away from Chinaglia. Now this is Moyers playing at the Cap. Heads it nicely for Rick Davis outside the box. Now to Giorgio trying to turn. Being held by Yaremovic, no foul. Chinaglia mad. Alberto, a nice intercept. Now it's Moyers. No penalties in this game. And there have not really been any penalties. I mean, two-minute penalties. It's been a hard, clean game. Parkinson with the ball. Deflected by Alberto. Davis to Carlos. Cap heads it down for Rick Davis. At the midfield line with 11:25 to play in the Cosmos, down by two. The Steve Moyers in the corner. Fran O'Brien after him. O'Brien makes the play at the point to Carlos. Dummy through by Davis for Cap. Shot. Rigby. Good release to Hill. He's got Carlos to beat. He beat him. Off the boards to himself, and a great save, and another great save, and the ball hit the post. Great steal by Hill, who may be hurt.
Terrific piece of individual work by Hill. I think he is hurt. I think he may have crashed into the boards after that great wall pass to himself. And how the Cosmos escaped that one, we'll never know. We're going to take another look at it. Here's Hill getting around Carlos. Now watch him play a little quick ball off the wall, and he hits it in. Now he's got a great rebound. I think he got a kick, actually, there. A defender reached in and tried to knock the ball away and just caught him in the stomach, and that's the problem. He did not crash into the board, so he should be okay.
Another great save by that man, David Bursic. The Cosmos and Soccer Camps of America are once again proud to offer children from the ages of 8 to 16 years the finest in soccer instruction. For more information on the Cosmos Soccer Camps, the Giorgio Chinaglia Soccer Academy, and the Pelé Soccer Camps, call 201-460-7100. I can testify to the quality of those camps, because my son had occasion to work those camps last year. Came back and told me that it's just wonderful. The instruction that those kids get is tremendous.
Well, Erhard Kapp, I think, was the defender reaching in there, Jim, and injuring Hill. Let's see. There you see him playing the ball around Ricky Davis, and here's Kapp coming through. And I think it's as he goes for the header is where the injury takes place. You see Kapp reaching up, and he kicks him.
Well, that was Ricky Davis, I think, that came over there.
It was Kapp. Ricky Davis had made the initial play and was out of it to the right, but it was caught him right in the groin. I think he's okay, though.
Yeah.
But Hill is really playing so well. I mean, he's got how many goals he got? One, two, three, four goals tonight.
Yeah.
So it's going to be a drop ball now. And by the way, that goal by Wegerle was his second of the night, his third for the season. He's got to become a bit more productive for the Cosmos. He's the most experienced player, and they're really hoping that he'll get some goals for them. Giorgio Chinaglia got an assist on that goal.
Hill got away from Rick Davis. Off the boards. And Durgan pushed the man from behind. That's a foul. Push Usian. That was a good pass by Hill. He banged it off the boards. He knew that Usian was on that side. Usian was right there. Durgan a bit behind him, pulled him down. The attendance tonight announced at 8,715. 8,715. Not bad with these weather conditions, Seamus.
Well, it's a good turnout. They'd hope to get over 10, but it's been a dreadful day. Here's a bad foul down there by Usian. But Moyer's on his feet. He's okay.
Free kick, Cosmos. 10:33 to play in the game. 6-4 Montreal over Cosmos. Alberto bangs it to the corner to Moyers. Yuremovich is with him. Good pass to Davis. Drives it off the boards. Good shot by Rick. Just missed. Moussian. Playing it for Hill. Nice play by Durgin. Now to Alberto. Carlos to Moyers. Could not trap it well.
Well, Moyers, he didn't trap it well. He's a bit tired. He just came running off. And you get tired, you know, after 3 or 4 minutes of running in this. And, of course, a chance like that for an important trap, or a good trap is important, rather. If you're really tired, you simply won't make the good trap.
All right, Durgin on the boards, and a whistle blows. Foul on Durgin. Usian playing with Alberto. Bursich throws it out to a wide-open Di Matteis. He's got G trailing. Chinaglia high to the corner. G. And now it's Usian. Usian who scored a goal tonight. Baden Knight a bad pass. But G could not pick it off. And the ever steady Voesmaer. Good play by Durgin. Daryl G on the boards. Now Alberto. Di Matteis in the corner. Voesmaer came over to steal and a nifty little back heel to Usian.
Well, Ferdinando just simply not sharp enough there in that situation. He's got to go with much more urgency into the corner and get that ball. Look around over his shoulder. He just went in there blind and slowly.
Willie over to Hayden Knight in the left corner. To Willie. Durgin again broke it up. Di Matteis is out hustled. Well, not out hustled, but out maneuvered, I think, Seamus. Shot is blocked. Another shot. Willie and Durgin gets in the way of Willie. Durgin was kicking at Bursich. Willie was kicking at Bursich, and Durgin wasn't about to let that happen. In that case, Durgin is correct, because in any form of soccer, indoor and outdoor, you cannot let an offensive player kick at your goalkeeper. I mean, what Durgin is saying to the referee is that Bursich had the ball, and Willie continued to kick at the ball. And now, Peter Johnson and Willie and Durgin having a little discussion, there'll be no penalty.
Well, there is going to be a penalty.
Oh, now it's 2 minutes for Durgin. All right, 2 minutes. The first penalty of the game.
It's a yellow card, too. I think I wouldn't be surprised if Willie isn't going out, too. There should be matching penalties. Well, you see Willie really stretching in there, but Jeff loses composure a little bit and does go after him. But they're both going to the bench. A yellow card to Willie. And 2 minutes for each of them. So the first penalties of the night come after 6 minutes and 36 seconds have elapsed in the fourth quarter.
All right, 8:24 to play in the game. So each team playing with a man down. All right, Bursich will have a goal kick. The Cosmos have Wegele, Alberto, Chinaglia, and Vandoff in the game. Usian, Knight, Voesmaer, and Yuremovich. Now, this is really dangerous, Seamus, because when you take one player from each club, it just opens the game up more.
Yeah.
But maybe that's what the Cosmos need. But that's why you have two speedsters for Montreal. They've got Usian and Knight on the field, because this is an open field now.
That's right. And you've also you've got to have some speedsters out there for the Cosmos. You've got Boris Bandoff, who can move, and Steve Wegele, of course. And Carlos Alberto doesn't have the speed he used to have, but he's got all the savviness back there.
All right, Wegele, one-on-one, deflected. Steve plays it to Carlos, heads it in the slot, knocked out by Yuremovich. It's fanned off to Giorgio, back to Wegele at midfield. Wegele had to get rid of it quickly under pressure. It's a bad pass by Giorgio. Here's Usian. Nice pass, Yuremovich. Took too much time. Can't take time in this game, Seamus. Good pass by Bandoff to Chinaglia at midfield. Giorgio plays it on the left now for Bandoff. As the Cosmos attack with three players. One back, that's Escandurian, in for Alberto. Giorgio shot, and Rigby never saw it as it bounced behind him.
Giorgio getting a nice move around Yuremovich there to get free for that shot, but he just was unlucky as it just went off the post.
Ardeski did well to knock it back to Bursich with seven 11 remaining in the game. 6-4 Montreal. Now Bandoff. We have 41 seconds to go in the double penalties to Willie and Durgan. Right, here's Eske. Parkinson on him. Eske's shot goes wide. Knight in the corner with Weggley. Weggley got there first. And Voesmaer came to take it away. And he's tipped from behind by Weggley. Now Voesmaer asking for a two-minute penalty.
Steve, pretty upset about losing that ball. He had won it well on the boards and then lost it to the skill there of Voesmaer, who dribbles away beautifully, moving the ball across his body as he senses the challenge from behind. And, of course, that means he is taken down.
Right, Hill back in the game for Montreal. What a night he's had. Four goals. Gordon Hill with Escondarian on him. Hill holding on the ball. We have 3 seconds on the penalty. And Eske's fouled Hill with 1 second. Ricky Davis intercepts, Eske intercepted. Now Davis got it to Durgan just out of the box. Jeff was run down by Willie. They came out of the box together. It looked like Durgan had a breakaway, but Willie caught up to him. Parkinson on the left for Fran O'Brien just saw it. Broken up by Moyers, who's just come out for the Cosmos. Cosmos down by two. 6 minutes to play in the game. Giorgio. Rigby's out. Now he's back in again as Mark Antonio marking. Moyers knocked it away. Nice clearance by Mark Antonio. And a lot of room for Fran O'Brien as Davis runs him down. In front, and Davis hit it last. It'll be corner kick Montreal.
O'Brien trying to pull the same move that Hill pulled on Ricky Davis a while ago, and he got hurt. But Ricky was ready for it that time, and as the ball came off the boards, he cut in front of Fran O'Brien as he went for his own return ball. Knocked it away for a corner.
Right, corner kick in front, and a save by Bursich. The Cosmos next telecast will be on Sunday, January the 3rd, from Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto. That'll be a 3 p.m. game. Catch all the action on WOR-TV as the Cosmos try to avenge last week's loss to the Toronto Blizzard. Hill a miss. Sutevsky. He was hoping that Parkinson was going to go in deep. Now a long release to Moyers. Banged it in the corner to Giorgio. Chinaglia had it knocked away. Mark Antonio's done a good job on Giorgio. Now the shot by Davis. Throw is picked off by Eske. Nice skill by Escondarian. Eske for the Cosmos with 4:52 off the boards. Mark Antonio. Davis intercepts. Gets into the stands.
Good hustle by Ricky Davis there. Unfortunately, the shot wasn't a bit more powerful. Ricky, of course, has a very strong shot, and in fact, in the power plays, the Cosmos haven't had one tonight, but in the power plays, Ricky is a player that they go to outside for those driving shots from near out near the red line or in a bit near that area. But the Cosmos looking pretty good now the last few minutes, getting some good opportunities, advancing the ball well, but just simply not getting the finishing touches.
Well, the clock is their enemy now, ticking away with 4:35, and Montreal leading by two. Again, it was Hill giving it to himself off the boards, creating havoc. And when the ball came free, it was that man, Fran O'Brien, that knocked it in the corner. And it's Montreal by three.
Unfortunate there, because now watch how Carlos anticipates as well. He's ready for it. He comes for it. He does a good job knocking it away. But unfortunately, Bursich did not think that Carlos would get to it. So he came out to smother the attack. We get another look at it now. And unfortunately, came back. See, Carlos has won it, really, but David has anticipated is not winning it and has gone for the player getting the ball, leaving it free for O'Brien to have the easiest touch-in of the night.
By 7-4, Montreal trying to beat the Cosmos for the first time, indoor or outdoor. All right, now here's Cap, Earhart Cap on the left. Bangs it in front. Chinaglia's got a chance, trying to get it to G, and it was broken up by Mark Antonio. Here's Hill again. To Andy Parkinson in the corner. Back to Hill. Alberto intercept. Carlos. Nice pass to Moyers. Moyers. Hayden Knight came back to make the play on Moyers. Good speed by Knight. Now Usien comes on. Hill has the ball, and he gave it right to Usien, who just came on. Usien came over the boards and had a great chance and missed. Hayden Knight and Usien, along with Hill from Montreal. And Marc Antonio again away from Chinaglia. Carmine's done the job on Giorgio. And now Moyers. Moyers over the line. 7-4 Montreal. Moyers passed too high for Cap.
Well, that's too bad. That's the second time, really, Steve has come down there on good opportunities and hit high passes rather than accurate low passes.
Lucien's pass went off Hayden Knight. Cosmos get it back. Standoff with 3 minutes to play. Cosmos down by three. Durgin's on. DeMatteis is on. Durgin's shot. Good save by Rigby. Came through a screen of players, and Riggs did well to get down on it. 2:49 to play. Montreal looks like they're going to beat the Cosmos for the first time. 7-4 is the score, and the clock reading 2:40 in the game. Knight to Usien. Durgin got there first and banked it off to Bursic. Chinaglia, nice pass to Bandoff. Boris off the glass. Rigby dove, so Chinaglia would have no chance. And a good play by Rigby.
Unfortunately, the glass is not as it's more resilient than the wood, and therefore the bounce wasn't as forceful. Had he hit the wood on that cross, I think Giorgio would have had a good chance.
All right, great pass to O'Brien. One-on-one. Bursic made the play. Open goal and a goal by O'Brien. O'Brien, again, opportunistic goal, but what a pass to get him free, Seamus. A great pass to send Franny in. On goal.
Hill, the terrific pass that beats everybody. O'Brien comes in. He's just got Bursic to beat now. He hits it too hard, but doesn't get rattled. It takes his time and volleys it in the far corner. Terrific combination worked over between Hill and O'Brien. Hill, by the way, got the assist on the O'Brien goal a minute ago. This is Franny O'Brien's second goal, his third of the season. Hill's second assist, his third of the season, second assist of the night. So he has two assists and four goals, 10 points tonight. Really a remarkable effort by Hill.
Here comes Durgin, battling along the boards. Durgin's a man possessed down there. I think he's mad. Voesmaer. Now they get it to Marc Antonio. Good pass to Chudin. But Bandoff got there first in the corner. But Chudin got the ball. Chudin, who scored a header goal tonight. O'Brien, he's had a couple. Hill's had four. Is O'Brien. Usien had the other goal. Cosmos two by Wegley. Ball came free, and Bursic dove on the foot of Alan Woolley to pick it off. Bursic may have shaken himself up on the play. May have hurt his shoulder. Voesmaer. No, I think he hurt his left elbow. And now the referee calls time. Bursic says, that's okay, I'm all right. He hurt his left shoulder. They're checking his left elbow, diving at the feet of Alan Woolley. And Peter H. Johnson, the reason I keep using his middle initial is there's two referees in the league, Peter T. Johnson and Peter H. Johnson. This is Peter H. from Northern Virginia. Originally from England.
Originally from Leeds, as a matter of fact. I flew up with him in the plane this morning from Boston, and he's hoping to slip away to England for Christmas time or shortly thereafter. But it's just as bad over there as it is in Montreal at the moment from the point of view of weather. Now here's the save again. We're taking a look at Dave Bursic on the screen. But he's okay.
All right, Rigby throws it out to Woolley. A minute to play in the game. And Montreal has finally beaten the Cosmos. 8-4 Montreal. They'll go to 2-2. Cosmos will go to 1-3. And are looking forward to home cooking, Seamus, on the 29th. Now Chinaglia couldn't bring it under control. Jacksonville the 29th, the Cosmos next game. And this three-game road trip, in the words of Giorgio Chinaglia, has been disastrous.
Has been disastrous. Giorgio not scoring tonight, but here's a chance.
Oh. Okay, right by Ricky Davis.
It skimmed right off Marc Antonio's ankle. He never saw it, but otherwise it was a goal for Ricky. Giorgio has two assists tonight.
Well,
Seamus, no goals.
Four games into an 18-game season. Not even a quarter of the way through. So the Cosmos still have a chance, but they're going to have to get their act together. And they can do that at home. in the slot for Giorgio. O'Brien marking it off now. 2 seconds, 1 second, and that's it. In the form of Montreal, Steve Wegley's two goals weren't nearly enough. And Montreal, a good job, I think, tonight. Marc Antonio played Giorgio well as you can play Giorgio. And the Cosmos, an 8-4 loser to Montreal. All right, Seamus and I will be back with a recap. Final, Montreal 8, Cosmos 4. You're watching Cosmos Indoor Soccer.
It's the West. The West you feel inside of yourself.
All right, for Montreal tonight. The Manic beat the Cosmos for the first time ever, and they beat them 8-4 here in the Forum in Montreal. And the Cosmos now will go home for Christmas and get their forces together and take on Jacksonville at the 29th at the Meadowlands Arena, Seamus.
Well, I think the important thing for the Cosmos is they got to realize that scoring three goals a game or a little over three goals a game in this sport just simply isn't enough. And they're going to have to get the attack ready for the Jacksonville team when they come in, because that's where they're going to start turning this thing around, Jim.
All right, that's it from Montreal. Merry Christmas. Happy Hanukkah. Have a nice holiday season. We'll see you on the 29th. The Meadowlands, the Cosmos in Jacksonville. Montreal wins it here tonight, and they deserved it. They played well. They beat the Cosmos 8-4.